example, we are going to find the electric field due to a point charge moving with velocity v. So in the previous semester, we have found the electric field due to a stationary charge, and that electric field is given by the Coulomb's law. So Coulomb's law, as we know, is valid only for the static charges, the charges which are at rest. But here we are going to find out what the electric field looks like when the charge is moving, when the point charge is moving with velocity v. So first of all, we are going to consider an S frame. So this is the inertial frame of reference S, and we have a charge Q. So this Q charge, let's suppose, is moving with velocity v along plus x axis direction with respect to S frame. So if you have an observer, let's say O1, so O1 is the observer present in S frame, and this charge Q is moving with velocity v in this direction. So according to this observer, the charge is moving with velocity v along the plus x axis direction. So this is similar to the fact that, let's say, there is a charge in space and the charge is moving. So according to you, the charge is moving. So you are in S frame and the charge is moving with a certain velocity. And the S prime frame is attached to the charge Q. So the frame is also moving with velocity V. So this S prime frame is attached with the charge Q, means this S prime is the rest frame of the charge. Any observer which is present in S prime frame, for any observer, this charge will be at rest, because the observer will also be moving with velocity v in the S prime frame. So in the S prime frame, if you have any observer, according to him, the charge will be at rest. So S prime is the frame which is moving with velocity v with respect to O1. According to O1 observer, the frame is moving with velocity v. This charge is moving with velocity v, and this observer O2 is also moving with velocity v along the plus x axis direction with respect to S frame, or you can say with respect to any observer which is present in S frame. So here we are considering a point charge Q which is moving with velocity v along plus x axis direction with respect to S frame. So this charge Q is moving with velocity v with respect to S frame, or with respect to any observer which is present in S frame. And S prime frame, which is the S prime frame, is the one which is attached to the charge Q. So S prime frame, this is attached to the charge Q. So as the charge is moving, this frame will also move with the same velocity. So if there is any observer present in S prime frame, according to him, the charge will be at rest. So we can call this S prime frame as the rest frame of the charge Q. So this S prime frame can be called as the rest frame of charge Q. So any observer present in S prime frame, for any observer, according to him, this charge will be at rest. And S is the frame, this S frame is the frame in which the charge is moving with velocity v along x-axis direction. So in the S prime frame, the charge is at rest. So if you want to find the electric field in S prime frame, so let's say there is a point P in space and you want to find the electric field at this point P due to the charge Q in S prime frame. As we know that in S prime frame, this charge is at rest. So for any observer in S prime frame, this charge will be at rest. And if this observer wants to find the electric field at a point P in space due to this charge, so he will use the simple Coulomb's law. So as we have done in the previous semester, when the charge is at rest, we use the Coulomb's law to find the electric field. So for this observer, the charge is at rest. So if he wants to find the electric field at a point in space, so he will use the Coulomb's law. So if he wants to find the electric field at this P point in space, and let's say this is the origin of the S prime frame. So the origin of the S prime frame is moving along the x-axis direction with respect to the S frame. So let's say the position vector of this P point. To find the electric field at P point, first of all, we define the position vector. So the position vector of this point in S prime frame is given by R prime vector. So every quantity in S prime frame will be denoted by a prime. So R prime vector is the position vector of this point P, this observation point P in the S prime frame. So what will be the electric field at point P in the S prime frame? In S prime frame, what will be the electric field? We will use the simple Coulomb's law. So electric field at any point P in S prime frame is given by E prime vector. So the electric field at this point due to this charge in S prime frame is represented by E prime vector, and that will be nothing but equal to charge Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R prime vector divided by R prime Q. So this is how we write the expression of electric field. So the electric field is generally given by Q by 4 pi epsilon naught by R square times R cap. So this is how we used to write the expression of electric field. And then when you multiply this by magnitude of R vector and divide it by the magnitude of R vector, so you will get R vector. R into R cap will be R vector, and R square into R will be just R cube. So here I have written the same expression, but instead of R, I am using R prime, because R prime vector is the position vector of this observation point in S prime frame. So instead of R, I am using R prime. So the electric field will be given by this expression, and R prime vector is equal to X prime I cap plus Y prime J cap plus Z prime K cap. So as in the previous semester, we used to write R vector as X I cap plus Y J cap plus Z K cap. So in this case, we are using R prime vector as the position vector in S prime frame. So this can be written as X prime I cap plus Y prime J cap plus Z prime K cap. So in this case, we are going to substitute this formula, and that will be equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught as it is R prime vector. So we will write this R prime vector afterwards. First of all, we are going to write the magnitude of R prime and its cube. So cube of the magnitude of R prime vector. So magnitude of R prime vector will be, its magnitude will be under root of X prime square plus Y prime square plus Z prime square. So we can write this as R prime cube. So this can be written as X prime square plus Y prime square plus Z prime square. Its under root means power 1 by 2. And we also have power 3. So you will write it as 3 by 2. And R prime vector can be written as X prime I cap plus Y prime J cap plus Z prime K cap. Now we will divide this electric field. So this is the expression of electric field at P point due to the charge Q in S prime frame. And S prime frame is the rest frame of the charge Q. Therefore, we have used the simple Coulomb's law equation of the electric field. Now in this case, you can see that we have three components of electric field. One is along x-axis, another one is along y-axis, and the last one is along z-axis. So we can divide this electric field into three components. So what will be the x component of the electric field represented by Ex prime? So we write it as Ex prime. So this prime denotes that we are writing this quantity in the S prime frame. So Ex prime will be equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught is common. X prime divided by this expression will give me the X component. So this expression will be the X component, And similarly, you can write the y component of the electric field, and at last you can write the z component. So you can write the x component as q by 4 pi epsilon naught into x prime divided by x prime square plus y prime square plus z prime square power 3 by 2. So this is the x component of the electric field in the s prime frame. Then in the y prime frame, you have q by 4 pi epsilon naught as it is, because this is common to all the terms. So q by 4 pi epsilon naught and this term in the denominator is common to all the three terms. So the y component will be y prime divided by x prime square plus y prime square plus z prime square as it is. So the common term will remain as it is. And at last, the z component will be q by 4 pi epsilon naught z prime by x prime square plus y prime square plus z prime square power 3 by 2. So this is the x component of the electric field in s prime frame. This is the y component of the electric field in s prime frame. And this one is the z component of the electric field in the s prime frame. So in the s prime frame, the charge is at rest. So we have got these three equations of the components of the electric field in S prime frame. But what do we want to find? We want to find the electric field in S frame. Because in S frame, in this S inertial frame of reference, according to this observer O1, who is in S frame, according to this observer, this charge is moving with velocity V. According to this observer, this charge Q is moving with velocity V along x-axis, and we want to find the electric field due to a point charge Q moving with velocity V. So we want to find the expression of electric field when the charge is moving. So these are the expressions of the electric field when the charge is at rest. And these are the expressions in S prime frame, because S prime is the rest frame of the charge Q. But in S frame, according to this observer who is in S frame, according to him, the charge is moving. So he wants to find the expression of electric field in the S frame. So how do we find the expression of electric field? So what do we want? We want to find the electric field at the same point P. So this is the expression of electric field at P point in S prime frame. But we want to find the electric field S frame in the S frame at the same observation point P. At the same point P, we want to find the electric field, and that electric field will be due to a moving charge. So we want to find the electric field at the same point P as seen in the S frame, because in S frame the charge is moving. And now I'm going to tell you the whole derivation briefly. That what we are going to do in the whole derivation to find the electric field in S frame. So this is a long derivation, and most of the students, they lose the track in the whole derivation. So I'm just telling you briefly what are the various steps that we are going to do in the whole derivation. So in this case, what do we have? We have S frame. So there is no system in the S frame. The system is in the S prime frame. So S prime frame is moving with velocity V. So this charge is moving with velocity V. So there is no system which is at rest in S frame. So the charge is at rest in S prime frame, and there is no system at rest in S frame. So this charge is moving with velocity V, but in S prime frame, for an observer in S prime frame, the electric field will be given by simple Coulomb's law. And the electric field to an observer in S prime frame will look like this. So if you have a positive charge, and for this observer, this charge will be at rest. So according to him, the electric field will look like this. So the electric field will be spherically symmetric in the S prime frame, because in the S prime frame, the charge is at rest. So to any observer in S prime frame, the electric field will be spherically symmetric. But now we are going to find the electric field according to this observer, how the electric field lines look like for this observer. So for that, we have already found the electric field in S prime frame. We have found Ex prime, we have found Ey prime and we have found Ez prime. So we have found Ex prime in terms of x prime, y prime, z prime, Ey prime we have found, Ez prime we have found. But what do we want to find? We want to find Ex, Ey and Ez. So we already know Ex prime, Ey prime, Ez prime, but we want to find Ex, Ey, Ez. So if we get to find Ex, Ey, Ez, then we can easily find the total electric field, because total electric field in S frame, the electric field will be given by Ex I cap plus Ey j cap plus Ez k cap. So the expression of the electric field is this one. So if you get to find Ex, Ey, Ez, then you can easily find the total electric field in the S frame at the point P. So now what do we have? We have Ex prime, Ey prime, Ez prime, and we want to find Ex, Ey, Ez. So here we are going to use the previous article of transformation of electric field. So there we have found that if you have a system, let's say like this, so this is the S frame and this was the S prime frame in the previous article, and we had some system, we had some plates which were at rest in S frame. So these parallel plates, these charged plates, they were at rest in S frame, and in S prime frame, this S prime frame was moving with velocity v. So in this S prime frame, for any observer in S prime frame, these plates were moving in the negative x axis direction. So these plates, they were at rest in the S frame, but they were moving as seen from the S prime frame. But in our case, in this case, we have the opposite situation. In this case, in S prime frame, the charge is at rest. In S prime frame, the charge is at rest, but in S frame, the charge is moving. In the previous article, in S frame, the system was at rest, but in S prime frame, the system was in motion. So in this particular scenario, we have found that Ex prime, the electric field in a moving frame. So this was the moving frame in that case. But in our case, this is the moving frame, because S prime frame is the rest frame of the charge. So charge is moving with velocity v with respect to S frame, but this S prime frame, which is attached to the charge, this is the rest frame of the charge. So in this article, in the previous article, we had this S frame, which was the rest frame of this system. So we had the opposite condition over there. So in that derivation, we have found that Ex prime is equal to Ex and Ey prime is equal to gamma times Ey and Ez prime is equal to gamma times Ez. So these were the transformation equations of electric field we found in the previous derivation. And now we want to find Ex, Ey, Ez. In this case, we know Ex prime, Ey prime, Ez prime, and we want to find Ex, Ey and Ez. So we are going to use these equations, but we have to modify these equations a little bit, because in this derivation, in the derivation of these equations, we had taken the S frame as the rest frame of the system, and S prime frame was the one in which the system was moving, in which these plates were moving. But in our case, we have the S prime as the rest frame. S prime is the rest frame and S is the frame in which the charge is moving. So in this case, the transformation equations must be modified. So in our case, what will be the transformation equations? So wherever you have prime, from there you will remove the prime, and wherever you do not have prime, there you will write the prime. So Ex prime is equal to Ex, so the equation will be Ex is equal to Ex prime, and we have Ey prime as gamma times Ey, so this equation will be modified, so this will be Ey is equal to gamma times Ey prime, and Ez will be equal to gamma times Ez prime. So in this particular system, in the previous derivation, we had seen that the electric field along the direction of motion remains the same. And the electric field in the perpendicular directions get increased by a factor of gamma. The electric field in the perpendicular direction increases by a factor of gamma. So the electric field in the S prime frame will increase by a factor of gamma. The perpendicular component of electric field will increase by a factor of gamma. So Ey and Ez will be gamma times Ey and Ez respectively. But in this case, the charge is at rest in S prime frame. So the perpendicular component of the electric field will increase by a factor of gamma in S frame. So in S frame, the charge is moving, the system is moving. So in S frame, the perpendicular components means Ey and Ez, these will increase by a factor of gamma. They will get multiplied by a factor of gamma. So Ex will be equal to Ex prime. Ey will be equal to gamma times Ey prime. And Ez will be equal to gamma times Ez prime. So that we have got over here. So we have modified these equations because in both these situations, the condition is completely opposite. So in this case, the S frame was the rest frame and we found the electric field in S prime frame. But in this case, the S prime is the rest frame and we have to find electric field in the S frame. So we have to modify these equations. So now using these equations, we will find Ex, Ey and Ez. So we will find Ex and that is just equal to Ex prime. So Ex prime is nothing but this expression. And Ey is equal to gamma times Ey prime. So that will be gamma times Ey prime. So Ey prime, we already know its expression that is given by this one. And last one is Ez is equal to gamma times Ez prime. And Ez prime is given by this one. But here you can see that we want to find Ex, Ey and Ez. So these are the quantities in S frame. And on the right hand side, what you will get X prime, Y prime, Z prime. So we will also use the Lorentz transformations. We will use the Lorentz transformations to write x prime, y prime, z prime in terms of x, y, z. Because on the left hand side, we have the quantity in the S frame. So on the right hand side, we also must have the quantities that are measured in S frame. So on the right hand side also, we will try to write the expression in x, y and z. So we will use the Lorentz transformations. So what are they? X prime is equal to gamma times x minus vt. So wherever you will have x prime, there you will use gamma times x minus vt, and y prime will be equal to y, and z prime will be equal to z. So Ex will be equal to Ex prime. And what is Ex prime? We have solved. It is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught into x prime divided by x prime square plus y prime square plus z prime square power 3 by 2. And Ey is written as gamma times Ey prime. So that will be equal to gamma times q by 4 pi epsilon naught into y prime over x prime square plus y prime square plus z prime square power 3 by 2. So we are just writing down the expressions of Ex prime, Ey prime and Ez prime. So gamma times Ez prime. So that will be equal to gamma times q by 4 pi epsilon naught z prime by x prime square plus y prime square plus z prime square power 3 by 2. Now over here we are going to use the Lorentz transformations. We are going to write x prime as, so wherever we have x prime, we will write it as gamma times x minus vt, and wherever we have y prime and z prime, there you will write only y prime, or there you will write just y and z respectively. So wherever you have x prime, so q by 4 pi epsilon naught as it is. So wherever you have x prime, you will write it as gamma times x minus vt divide by, here you have x prime, it will be gamma times x minus vt whole square plus y prime is equal to y, so this will be y square, and z prime is equal to z, it will be z square power 3 by 2, and this will be equal to gamma times q by 4 pi epsilon naught, y prime is equal to y over x prime is equal to gamma times x minus vt whole square plus y square plus z square power 3 by 2, and at last you have gamma into q divide by 4 pi epsilon naught z divide by gamma times x minus vt whole square plus y square plus z square power 3 by 2. So here we have simply used the Lorentz transformation equations. And now over here we are going to take gamma square common. So in this case we have gamma whole square, that will be gamma square. So we are going to take gamma square common from the denominator. From the square bracket, we are going to take gamma square common, and similarly in this case also, we are going to take gamma square common, and in this case also, we are going to take gamma square common. So this will be q by 4 pi epsilon naught as it is, gamma times x minus vt as it is, divide by, so what we are going to do is, we are going to take gamma square. So when you will open this bracket, you will have gamma square into x minus vt whole square. So we are going to take this gamma square common. So when you will take gamma square outside this whole bracket, so gamma square power 3 by 2 will also go along with it. So gamma square power 3 by 2 will be equal to gamma cube. So when you are taking gamma square common from all these terms inside the square bracket, when that gamma square will come outside, that will become gamma square power 3 by 2, and that will be just gamma cube. And inside the bracket you will have x minus vt whole square. So gamma square has been taken outside, plus y square plus z square divide by gamma square power 3 by 2 as it is. And the similar thing you will do over here, gamma times q by 4 pi epsilon naught y divide by, you are taking gamma square common, so that will become gamma cube, and you will have x minus vt whole square plus y square plus z square by gamma square power 3 by 2. And in the last z component, you will have gamma q by 4 pi epsilon naught z divide by gamma q into x minus vt whole square plus y square plus z square by gamma square power 3 by 2. Now over here this gamma will cancel with this one, and you will be left with gamma square in the denominator, and similarly over here also you will have gamma square in the denominator, and similarly over here also you will have gamma square in the denominator. And now what is gamma square? So firstly, what is gamma? Gamma is given by 1 by under root of 1 minus v square by c square. So what will be gamma square? Gamma square will be 1 by 1 minus v square by c square. And this v by c is represented by beta. So you will study in special theory of relativity, v by c is written as beta. So this will be equal to 1 by 1 minus beta square, because we have v square by c square. So what will be gamma square? That is 1 by 1 minus beta square. So over here you have 1 by gamma square. So when you will substitute gamma square as 1 by 1 minus beta square, so you will substitute it as 1 by 1 minus beta square, that will go in the numerator. So Ex will be equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught x minus vt. So here you are substituting 1 by 1 minus beta square, so that will go in the numerator, and that will become 1 minus times 1 minus beta square divide by x minus vt whole square plus y square plus z square, and here also we have divide by gamma square, so that will be 1 minus beta square power 3 by 2 as it is. And the y component of the electric field in S frame will be equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught into y times, you have 1 by gamma square, so gamma square is 1 by 1 minus beta square, so that will go in the numerator, so that will be times 1 minus beta square divided by x minus vt whole square plus y square plus z square times 1 minus beta square power 3 by 2. And similarly you will have the z component, and that will be q by 4 pi epsilon naught z times 1 minus beta square whole divided by x minus vt whole square plus y square plus z square times 1 minus beta square power 3 by 2. So these are the x, y and z components of the electric field in terms of x, y, z in the S frame. And what will be the total electric field? Total electric field at the observation point P in the S frame. So in the S frame, the total electric field is given by Ex I cap plus Ey j cap plus Ez k cap. So when you will write, club all these terms, Ex I cap plus Ey j cap plus Ez k cap. So you can see that in all these terms, you have q times 1 minus beta square common, q times 1 minus beta square, q times 1 minus beta square, and you have this 4 pi epsilon naught, and this whole term is common. So this denominator is common in all these terms. So when you are writing Ex I cap plus Ey j cap plus Ez k cap, so the common terms I am taking directly outside. So common term is q times 1 minus beta square over 4 pi epsilon naught x minus vt whole square plus y square plus z square times 1 minus beta square power 3 by 2. So this term I have taken as common, and I have Ex I cap plus Ey j cap plus Ez k cap. So from all these terms, this term is taken common. And what I'm left with? I'm left with x minus vt in the first term. In the second term, I'm left with y. And in the third term, I'm left with z. So that will come separately in the bracket. So that will be x minus vt I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. So this is the net electric field at the observation point P in the S frame. As you can see, this electric field is dependent upon the velocity. So it is dependent upon the velocity v. So therefore, the electric field for a moving charge is not the same as that of the electric field when the charge is at rest. So the electric field for a moving charge is completely different as compared to when the charge is at rest. So in this case, when you will put velocity tends to zero, so in this case when the velocity of the charge tends to zero means it is becoming a static charge. So velocity tends to zero, in that case you will just have over here x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. So in that case beta is nothing but equal to v by c. So if v tends to zero, beta will also tend to zero. So this beta will go to zero, and over here this beta will go to zero, and this v into t expression, this will go to zero. So when v tends to zero, we will see in the next lecture that when v tends to 0, this expression of the electric field is the same as that of the electric field when the charge is at rest. So when v tends to 0, this electric field expression approaches to the same expression of the electric field when the charge is at rest. So this is a very important derivation to find the electric field in a frame in which the charge is moving. So we have found the electric field in the S frame, because in the S frame the charge Q is moving with velocity.